They've come from all over the US and Southern Canada. Literally 125 million monarchs are clustered within the size of about 5 football fields. Whenever you're looking up at the trees, it just looks like brown leaves on the trees. And you realize it's millions of butterflies. In the spring and summer, you'll find them all across the United States and Southern Canada. Here in Michigan, we're starting to see monarchs show up actually right around now. But whenever the fall comes, they'll all actually make this migration that's up to 2,500 miles to these very specific locations in central Mexico. The monarchs that will go there have never been there before. One of the biggest mysteries about how this all happens is that in the spring and summer, you have reproductive monarchs who are laying eggs and who live for about 5 to 7 weeks or so, and then they will die. But in the fall, their behavior is completely different. Now they're flying in a very specific direction in order to make it to this specific location in Mexico. So the big question is, it's the same genome, it's the same DNA that's leading to these very different kind of types of monarchs. How exactly does that happen? I've been trained as a geneticist and I'm interested in what are the genes that allow monarchs to find their specific location, fly 2,500 miles. How is that able to happen? What environmental cues are they using in order to navigate their path? How do they know when to leave? All of these questions are completely open. As a geneticist, I know that the answer is within the DNA and how that DNA is expressed. Because the environment differs, it gives different instructions to the DNA, and that leads to these very different types of monarchs. And my research is ultimately trying to figure out what are those instructions, so what are the environmental instructions, and then what are the relevant genes, what are the relevant pieces of DNA that are interpreting those instructions in order to lead to a butterfly that's 0.5 gram to fly 2,500 miles.